Jet injectors. They've been around for a while.
Yes, they have. And you know, Nigel, I've seen these things since the 60s, you know, Star Trek, right? And the old hypo sprayers go right through the shirt and they inject these things. What's the state of art with jet injectors?
Well, you know, they're still around. There's still plenty of products that are out there, and they, you know, are still very appealing for their ease of use and some of the benefits they have over things like microneedles on one end or syringes on the other. Generally, besides the ease of use, the other general appeal, of course, is less pain. So, you know, the theory is, you know, if you've got a needle and inside the needle is your drug, you know, you've got a certain diameter when you add the two together, the drug plus the needle. And, you know, of course, the idea is that diameter equals pain. So the wider the needle, the more painful the injection. But if you get rid of the metal part, then all you've got is that stream of liquid. If you can just kind of apply a bunch of pressure and jet it in there, then it'll be less painful. So they're around and they have their uses.
Yeah, one of the things that's always kind of bothered me a little bit about jet injectors, if you just think about the term jet, right? It evokes the thought of, you know, a spray of something, or even, you know, high pressure, at least, right? And if we think about it, I guess if it's in a laminar stream, that's one thing, but it's usually like a spray or something maybe. And that always concerns me when it comes to shear, right? Particularly if we think about, you know, the vaccine application and, you know, the state of art around vaccines these days, of course, is the solid lipid nanoparticles, where we have, you know, basically a way to protect mRNA in this vesicle. And if that gets sheared off, your mRNA is left out hanging in the breeze here, left out to dry, and that's the payload. And so that to me doesn't quite flange up with.
Yeah, that's right. And so there are some drugs that are essentially incompatible with jet injectors. And you're right also that there's often some side spray. And so if you're interested in not wasting drugs for super expensive drugs, there might be some downsides. And then, of course, there's always the cross-contamination issue that comes with elements that are non-disposable, right? So your capital equipment, that's kind of like the gun part, would be reused over and over again. And so obviously lots of protections in place, lots of, you know, methods to sterilize and wipe down in between. But at the end of the day, there's always that fundamental challenge of having to work against that cross-contamination.
Cool.
Yeah. So that's jet injectors. They're still around and they're still flying high.
Still flying high.
Flying high.